is that from some of the stuff that they do and what their model provides, and then you can answer your questions as well on that model. So please welcome Peter.
Can you hear me, or would you like me to use the mic?
We're not sure if we can.
Okay, well, in that case, I'll just be talking.
Sure.
It's a pleasure to be here, and I'm really excited about the fact that there's a group of people starting to work together in Regina to look at how you can accelerate solar power development in your city. The model that I'll talk about tonight is essentially what we've created in Saskatoon. There's lots of different ways to go, so I'm not saying that this is the only route to take, not at all, but it's an option for you to consider. Maybe we can just go to the first slide. We're the first renewable power co-op to set up in Saskatchewan. We actually originally wanted to form a wind farm co-op because we thought the economics of wind were a lot more attractive than solar, that we could get a large number of people involved. Sask Power discouraged us from doing that, but said that they would be willing to work with us if we formed a solar power co-op. And we thought about that for a while, decided that we would do that. And so SES Solar Co-op was established in early 2015. We could maybe go to the next slide. When we set our co-op up, we basically had two major goals in mind. One was to accelerate the adoption of solar power in the Saskatoon area. And the second was to reduce community greenhouse gas emissions. I think everybody in this room is probably concerned about climate change. One of the reasons that you're thinking about the idea of accelerating solar power in your community, and it was the same for us. We're really conscious of the fact that more than three quarters of the current Saskatchewan grid is fossil fuel based. It's about 46% coal and a quarter natural gas. And so the need to provide an alternative to that is really important. If you're comparing coal and solar power, the greenhouse gas